Do you take antioxidants to prevent heart disease and cancer? Millions of people do. Antioxidants such as vitamin C, vitamin E, selenium, beta-carotene, coenzyme Q10, among several others, are among the most common supplements I see on my patients' medication records. The typical reasons for taking antioxidants are promoting health, slow aging, and preventing heart disease and cancer. But do they really work? The story of antioxidants makes a lot of sense. Our normal metabolism creates potentially dangerous substances called free radicals. We can also be exposed to free radicals from toxins like cigarette smoke, excessive sun exposure, and pollution. The problem with free radicals is that they can cause cell damage, which is called oxidative stress. And that can lead to health problems like heart disease, dementia, diabetes, and cancer. Antioxidants are potentially helpful because they have been shown in laboratory studies to neutralize the free radicals. Also, many health foods like vegetables, fruits, nuts, and berries are high in antioxidants. This information led to the idea that antioxidant supplements would help prevent heart disease and cancer. And in early in my medical career, the antioxidant idea was trendy among physicians based on some early observational studies that were promising. During my Mayo Clinic training, I was blessed to have some of the brightest physicians in medicine as teachers, and several of them regularly recommended antioxidants to their patients, such as vitamin E, vitamin C, and coenzyme Q10, and resveratrol as well. However, physicians know that observational studies are not strong science. Those studies can be wrong because there are too many variables that can change the outcome that aren't controlled. We have also learned many times that logical ideas about how the body works doesn't always prove correct in real life. Therefore, to truly test the idea that antioxidants promoted better health, we needed well-designed research studies to know for sure. The results were a surprise to many. Dozens of randomized trials now have been looking at antioxidants and have now been completed. A few examples: one study of over 14,000 male physicians found no difference in prostate cancer or other cancers in those taking vitamin C and vitamin E. Another study of over 35,000 men showed selenium and vitamin E had no influence on prostate cancer rates. A study of over 39,000 women showed no effect on heart disease or cancer in those taking vitamin E. And a study of over 8,000 women showed no difference in developing diabetes in those taking vitamin C, vitamin E, and beta carotene. And lastly, a study of over 29,000 male smokers showed no difference in lung cancer with vitamin E, but an increase in lung cancer in those taking beta-carotene. Despite the promise, higher quality studies have not shown any benefit to taking antioxidant supplements, and in some cases, they have resulted in harm. The full story of antioxidants is not known yet. Although the evidence is solid that vitamin C, vitamin E, and beta-carotene do not improve health outcomes, and in the case of beta-carotene and vitamin E, maybe increase risk, there are still several unknowns about antioxidants. Would other antioxidants be effective? Are we given the right dose to the right people? Until we have those answers, here is my advice for my patients about antioxidants. Number one, get your antioxidants from real food. There is magic in real food that we just can't create in a pill. Number two, be wary of health claims for antioxidant supplements. Be especially wary when the claims come from those who are financially benefiting from you taking supplements. And number three, there are proven ways to dramatically lower your heart disease and cancer risk. They just don't come in a pill. The remarkable health-promoting benefits of regular physical activity, eating nutritious food, getting adequate sleep, avoiding toxins such as tobacco and excess alcohol are proven. If you are taking antioxidant supplements or considering it, I recommend talking to your doctor to understand the risks and benefits for you. This information is for educational purposes only and is not medical advice. Don't make any decisions about your medical treatment without first talking to your doctor. Thanks for watching. And if you want to learn more about living a long, healthy life you love, click the link below to learn more about how we help people increase their health span. And if you like this video, hit the like button below, share it with your friends, and be sure to hit the bell and subscribe.